What's going on, traders? Welcome to the channel. I'm John. That's Groot, the crypto man. We trade options here. All right, so we are going to cover the other stages of the wheel. I'm going to give you a wheel update. Looking good. Little spoiler here. Profits are great, so I'm going to recap those. But I do want to get into something important. So two things. Overall market is having a small correction, but as you've seen, the 50-day moving average, we always kind of correct near it, and then there is a slight bounce. So like I've been saying for a while, I'm feeling a little frothy on the market, so I'm not going heavy, but I'm waiting until we at least touch or get very near the 50-day moving average before I start kind of packing on more risk. So just keep that in mind if there's anyone looking there in the market. But a couple things here. Mara looking great. I'm just watching some support levels, as well as let's bounce that 50 again. You're seeing here. So I'm expecting maybe potentially more bullish moves in crypto and henceforth Mara as well. So based on that, it's time to close out my covered call, which is more of a bearish play or a neutralized play, and I want to let those shares run rampant. So I'll cover that, and then let's talk about Palantir. If you have not seen yesterday's video, I did a covered call trade in that. Just to give you a slight update, I'm already looking profitable. Check it out, already 40% profit here. So I should actually close that trade right now. So I'm going to buy to close. This is just my contract, the 29 call that I sold, and I originally sold it, I think it was about $53. So it says 53 cents multiplied by 100, which is 100 shares in a contract. That gives me $53, and of that 53, I have 41% profit. So time to take that. I'm going to enter that, and this will remove my obligation and my collateral of the 100 shares that I own in Palantir. So what does this mean from a more simple standpoint? Basically, I took my profits, and now I'm still holding on to those 100 shares of Palantir that I have. Those aren't at risk anymore. I'm going to let that have a chance for Palantir to move higher again before I basically reset the probabilities and jump in there. Now let's talk about the main events, the trade of the day, Mara. So we're looking here at Mara, and anyone who hasn't followed the wheel strategy, do check that out. I have a series, I think it's like 2 to 3 videos related to when I started this trade. Basically, we're on like step 2 or 3 of the wheel now. And what this means is I've been assigned 100 shares from my original trade and premium capture. When I did that, I collected $131. And then basically since then, since I've been owning these 100 shares, I've just been selling covered calls against those shares until they get called away. Now, my goal isn't necessarily, since I am somewhat bullish on Mara, my goal isn't to try my best to get these shares called away. My goal is to capture profits along the way. So that's kind of what I'm doing here. And you can see here, I sold this whopper of a trade, 29 call. I sold this call, and it's the September 10th expiration date. There's still 22 days remaining, as you can see here. And then as we slide over, you can see my original cost in this, like my credit received. I received $908 from the broker to set up this trade. Of that, I'm currently profitable $523. That is more than 50%. I'm gonna take profits. I have 22 days left. That means I have 22 days for this to potentially change on me, and maybe I'm less profitable or anything along those lines. But to give you an idea, my running total, my total profits now with this will put me at $759 in profits. I've done like 4 trades, and I'm sitting very profitable. 3 trades, I think it is. So original trade, second covered call, or no, first covered call, then second covered call. So I have 3 trades in. I'm sitting on $759 of pure premium profit. So I'm going to close that out. Let me get you the heck out of here. Just look at Palantir for a second while I close this trade. All right, so order is submitted and in. I'll put you here. So to give you an idea, now I just have only my 100 shares in Mara. Quick recap on this. With the wheel, you are lowering your cost basis, and that is exactly what I've done. So current profits put me at $759 in total pre-trades, basically almost $800. I've got no complaints about that at all, especially since it takes like 1 or 2 minutes to set up the trade and call it a day.
Good to go.
And from a cost basis standpoint, this now puts my running cost basis in Mara at $20.41. So these 100 shares I own, they are currently at a cost basis of $20.41. And my goal is to just kind of keep lowering that. I can even get this to zero, sometimes even in the negative. I've done this in the past with other stocks. It is a very powerful tool to have. Very nice to have, especially in like a retirement account where you can just kind of keep collecting those checks. But do always be careful. This is not a financial advice and there is always risk in the market. So don't go crazy. Don't go all out and don't get, we call it premium drunk, where you start going full tilt. You see like a lot of good premium out there, but they're usually on like maybe meme stocks and those are super volatile and they can go against you in a bad way. So just always be careful. Keep your risk in check.